folks, on the other side of this door is the one and only Emperor, BTW's most cunning athlete. And right now, we are at the door of his private training facility. And on the other side of this door, he's getting ready for the next big matchup. But folks, I know who it's against. It's the Honky Tonk Man. He doesn't know that, but I know that. And that's why the championship committee sent me out here to give this message to him. And folks, it's going to be something. Let's go on the other side here, and let's let the Emperor know this special, special message. Message from I came in from the red eye from Chi-Town, Chicago. I got an urgent message for you.
I did not order a massage. I wanted a massage, you idiot.
No, not a massage. I have an urgent message from BTW. They flew me out on the red eye from Chicago. You're going to be facing the Honky Tonk Man at the next BTW event. He's the longest running Intercontinental Champion. You're the longest running BTW Cruiserweight Champion ever. How do you feel about that matchup?
Intercontinental Champion indeed. Intercontinental imposter is more like it.
What if the fact if he hits that shit... Lampert! Bear with me, folks. Lampert! Lampert, what if... There you go, Lampert. Over here. What if he slaps that shake, row, and roll on you? Are you going to go down? Will it be lights out?
I am going to slap my Arc de Triomphe on him, and it will be en deux, trois, et au revoir.
Can I borrow a towel?
Oh,
I can't.
It's getting very drafty in here.
Thank you very much. Folks, bear with me.
The Honky Tonk Man, and then... where's my champagne? Yes.
Lemper, I need to ask you... Lemper, I need to ask you a few more... Folks, I believe Lemper's detained at the moment. This is Joe Castle on location. I'm out of here.
All right, it's time for our main event of the evening. This is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. It is a flag match, USA versus France. First, soon to be led to the ring by his manager, Hop Sing Lee. He's known as France's most cunning athlete. He's from Versailles, France, and weighs 90 kilos. It's the Emperor.
Yep, here he is, France's most cunning athlete, Le Emperor, representative of Big Time Wrestling, and actually it's Big Time Wrestling's production company that's putting on this event. You see the BTW logo there at the far bottom of your screen, and you just saw an interview with Joe Castle, who was one of the BTW play-by-play guys. And he's actually leaving BTW, I understand.
Yes. Now, allow me to take over from here. This is my big announcement. This right here, this match right here that you're about to see, is my last match for Oaktown Wrestling. I am moving to bigger and better things. I am going to the big leagues. Big Time Wrestling, here I come. And I'm leaving you behind in the dust. Let's see how you're going to survive without me.
What? You're going to big... Well, Big Time Wrestling's a great organization. I mean, it's bigger than OWA.
Exactly. And I'm moving up the ladder, and you're staying behind, Danzig.
Well, you know what? Actually, I have some news. Joe Castle is leaving. I understand an old play-by-play guy is coming back. Hank Renner Jr. is taking over that spot.
Oh, please. Hank Renner Jr. I have to share the spotlight with him now. First of all, I thought I'd leave one loser behind in the announcement. Now I got to... I gotta announce with somebody, another loser? Oh, please. Well, that's fine, because I'm moving up in the ladder, and you're staying behind, Danzig.
Actually, I think I might be taking over the production of BTW and their DVDs. Be behind the scenes.
In your dreams, Danzig. First of all, I am the voice they wanted behind the scenes. Dragon Dave, they knew ratings when they saw it. They knew quality when they saw it, and they hired me, and they're paying me very well, I might add.
Well, if you want a paycheck for tonight, you better do your job here and call this match.
I don't like your Americans with your shiny pointed fingernails. Your most boring trousers. Look at this idiot here. Those trousers are very
kiss it that way.
No, the American people do not love France, Le Emperor. Did you understand any of that?
Of course, I speak Japanese fluently. I'm a well-traveled man.
Knowing what brands of sushi is not enough.
Hails from Memphis, Tennessee, at a weight of 242 pounds, it's the Honky Tonk Man!
Yes, here he is, the longest reigning intercontinental champion of all time, and some say the greatest of all time. It is the Honky Tonk Man.
Well, let me, now tell me I don't have to watch this man dance. I didn't come to see him dance.
I did. We're here to see the Honky Tonk Man sing and dance in this flag match. And there he is, Honky Tonk Man holding Old Glory.
No, that's the American flag.
Yeah, you take care of that Frenchman, Honky Tonk Man. Yeah, that is the American flag. Honky Tonk Man is a patriotic American. And it would really just be such a shame to see the Honky Tonk Man lose this match and Lamper wave that French flag. We already heard enough about France with that promo and how he insulted the nice American fans we have here.
Now, first of all, Danzig, let's go back to my big announcement. Let's face it, you're going to miss me, right? You can't replace me, for one.
Are you going to miss me?
No.
Well, guess what? I'm coming to BTW too, but it'll be behind the scenes.
I seriously doubt that you...
I can make you look good. You better be good to me, kid.
First of all, I make myself look good.
Yeah. You made yourself look really good when you were talking to the Ballad Brothers and to the UK kid.
I don't want to hear it. Let's not bring that up again.
Turn it off. Keep that music going. That's not so fun. Thank you very much.
Honky Tonk Man, always an entertainer, one of the world's greatest entertainers.
I did not need to see that. I didn't come to hear the Honky Tonk Man sing this. I came to see some wrestling.
Well, you're gonna see some wrestling. Honky Tonk Man, one of the greats. Oh yeah, look at these two. Hop Sing Ling and Le Emperor. Yep, Hop Sing there to probably do some cheating to help Le Emperor try and win this match.
No. First of all, Emperor doesn't need any help.
He gets. Well, why does he have Hop Sing Lee there at ringside with him?
Support. Moral support.
We know what Hop Sing is. Hop Sing is his little yellow assistant. He's a little manservant. He does whatever Emperor tells him.
First of all, you wouldn't know anything about support, you know?
I don't need no support.
Although, by looking at you, you probably need some right now.
Yeah, well, look at you. Yep, and there's the bell. And we're underway here.
All right, let me see. Explain the rules here, Danzig, to the fans.
Well, it's simple. It's a basic wrestling match. Just the winner of this match gets to raise his country's respected flag at the end. And boy, it'll be a shame if we see that French flag. Already got in Lamper's tights. That's enough for me.
What do you got against the French? Well, how come you don't want to see that French flag?
The French are good people, but Lamper is such a despicable character. And what he said to these great fans here at Mare Island... I mean, I do not want to see that flag waving. That would just be too humiliating and such a disgrace.
I wouldn't mind.
You would
say that.
All right, but he's got his work cut out for this. Ain't just any opponent. Yeah, he's getting out of the ring really quick. Yeah, Lamper thinks he's being all clever, but the Honky Tonk Man is a very clever wrestler himself.
Let me ask you something here, Danzig. Is the Intercontinental title on the line?
Honky Tonk Man is not Intercontinental Champion. He has been Intercontinental Champion since like the late 80s.
I was just testing you.
Yeah. Yeah, well, back when the Intercontinental belt used to mean something. I mean, he held the longest reign, but he also holds the losing the title in the shortest amount of time when he lost it to the Ultimate Warrior.
That's true. I was there when it happened.
I was there, too. We're watching it on pay-per-view.
Yeah, I was there live, you know, because I'm always at the biggest events, you know, always there. Here's
a big lockup, finally. Lampard working honky-tonk man into the corner. Are we going to have a clean break here? Oh, a clean break.
What do you say about that? Give him some credit.
Lampard looks to be really proud of himself, like, oh, look, I broke clean.
Give him credit. Go ahead.
Honky Tonk Man doesn't appear to be amused.
Go ahead. Give him credit.
I am giving him credit. I always give credit where credit is due.
All right. Let me hear it.
Yeah, the Honky Tonk Man got a clean break from Lee Emperor. That is the truth.
There you go. Thank you very much. You're coming around there, Danzig.
Coming around nothing.
A little too late because I'm gone after this match.
Yeah, well, I won't be too far behind you. All right, we have an arm lock up there with Le Emperor working on the Honky Tonk Man.
That's right. And Le Emperor working on the arm there.
Yeah. And that's a French arm lock, and that's a French elbow, right?
Exactly. And, you know, he's wearing him down, wearing the Honky Tonk Man down.
Yeah.
Now, how much of a psychological advantage do you think Lemper has about having Hop Sing Lee in a ringside with Honky Tonk Man? You know,
it's a great psychological advantage. I mean, Honky Tonk Man needs Jimmy Hart here. Now that was a great team, Honky Tonk Man and Jimmy Hart.
Well, but they're not together anymore. So let's deal with the present, not the past.
If we had Jimmy Hart here, he'd keep Hop Sing Lee.